Hello, this is Cristofina Geronda from GIS Science TV, and today we are with Daniela Zocher, who is going to explain the UGB project. It's an Interreg project, and what are the aims of this project, and what kind of analysis they conduct here in Salzburg.
Okay, so for the project itself, it's a Central Europe project with lots of partners, also in Italy. Padua is a partner, then Zagreb in Croatia, Budapest, Prague and Krakow, and of course Salzburg. And the general aim of the project is to have in the end a manual, a smart governance manual for the planning and assessment of urban green. And there's three pillars. One is multi-level governance, one is public participation, and one is GIS. And we are responsible as a partner for the GIS part. We have also Padua and Zagreb in this working group. And we're trying to set up an indicator system to assess different levels, different purposes of urban green, starting from maintenance to attractiveness, ecological factors, and we built a model which can be used in different ways. So you take from the model what you believe is helping the goals in your region, and then calculate these indicators, and hopefully they will help you to assess the status of your green spaces and to monitor them and to find out whether there are some planning issues you have to keep in mind when you maybe declare an area to be for a new park or an ecological area or maybe also for agricultural use. So that's the basic for it. And here in Salzburg, I believe my colleague could give you some more input on that. I think it's better we switch to Günther, who is really doing the calculations and the implementation here in Salzburg region.
Thank you very much. What kind of analysis did you conduct here in Salzburg for the application of your indicators?
We use our indicator framework that Daniela just presented with the thematic pillars of maintenance, sustainability, attractiveness, profitability and fair supply. And we, based on that, we did some analysis to assess the qualities of green spaces in the functional urban area of Salzburg. We firstly defined some maintenance indicators like green share per grid cell or sealed surfaces per grid cell, also per capita and communities. And then we built up on that some recreational indicators, meaning we analyzed the path density, the infrastructural setting of green areas, and by this examined the quality of green spaces. When we overlay this with the population grid, then we came up with the fact that rural areas are more undersupplied than urban core zones. So then we thought about including other indicators, especially like ecological value, natural attractiveness, scenic beauty, and try to include like the presence of biotopes, of preservation zones, of other natural infrastructural elements, of quiet zones, for example, as well, and then came up with that rural areas are considering these categories are not so much undersupplied, but there is a high value also regarding these qualities.
For the collection of data, you used remote sensing techniques or also interviews, questionnaires or field work?
We didn't use much remote sensing technology. We focused on open source data from the regional authorities. And we are lucky enough that we have here much data in the state of Salzburg. other data that we included are the cataster to delineate the green areas, also land cover data and statistical data from the respective institutes, and also OpenStreetMap data especially for complementing these infrastructural setting of public green spaces.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.